Hello, and welcome to Lean Excel Solutions. In this tutorial, we will learn to create this scrolling chart in Excel. Let's have an overview first of when to use it. Suppose you have a large range of data, which you want to plot on a graph. Like, here is the data for 99 products. But, if we plot a graph for this range, it will be so congested and will not give a good visual impact. Instead of that, we can use a scrolling chart with a limited datasets to be visualized at a glance and move left-right with a scroll bar to view other data, like this. We are going to do this in three simple steps. Step 1. Add a scroll bar. Step 2. Create chart range with the help of Name Manager, includes offset function linked to scroll bar. And step 3, insert line chart and link to created chart range. So, let's get started. Let's copy the data into the new sheet. To add a scroll bar, go to the Developer tab and insert a scroll bar from Form Controls. If the Developer tab is not visible in your case, go to File, Select Options, and in Customize Ribbon, check the box in front of Developer. Now, right-click on the scroll bar and select Format Control. Click on this up arrow and select the cell for scroll bar output. Here we can see a scroll bar links with the cell O1. Now, let's create the formula first for the chart range. Let's use the offset function for it, and we will test it for the serial number column in the range. This is the syntax for offset function. First argument, reference. Let's select this cell as a reference. Second argument, rows. That is the number of rows, up or down from reference cell. This is nothing but the start point of the range or cell. Let's put 1 for the time being. Third argument, columns. That is the number of rows, left or right from reference cell. In this case, we want to remain on same columns, so let's skip it. Next argument, height, which means number of rows to be included in range, as it is written in a square bracket, is optional and not a mandatory argument. But in this case, we will use it to define the range height. Since we want to show 10 product name at a time in chart, let's put 10 here. We don't need to define the width, so let's skip this too. And press enter. As we can see here, the range is set for these 10 cells. If we change rows to 2, this range will shift down. So, let's replace it with this cell to make it dynamic. But, since the minimum value for the scroll bar is 0, it including this cell too. To fix it, go to Format Control and set the minimum value to 1 instead of 0. Also, let's understand what is incremental change and page change. If we click on these arrows, the range is shifting by one place. This is incremental change. And if we click inside the scroll bar, the range is shifting by 10 places. This is page change. For example, let's update the page change value to 5. And here we can see the range changing by 5 places. Now, let's copy this formula to define the name. Go to the Formulas tab. Click on Define Name and paste the copied formula in Refer To. Let's give it a name and click OK. For defining the range for product name and data, let's go back to Name Manager. Copy the serial number formula, click New. Paste it. And just change the reference cell from A1 to B1, which is the product name column. Repeat the same for the data range. To test it, just type equal to in a cell and start typing the created formula, select it, and press Enter. Same for the product name. You can see, these symbols differentiate that these are the inbuilt formulas, and this is the one we defined. Alright, the formulas are working fine. Now let's insert the line chart. To add the data, right-click on it, select Data, and click Add. Series name, scrolling chart. For the series value, select any cell in the sheet, and delete everything after the exclamatory mark. The remaining is the sheet name only. Then go to the Formulas tab, and under the drop-down of Use in Formula, click on Paste Name. Or you can directly press the F3 key on the keyboard. It will open a new tab. Select Data and click OK. The graph is updated. Now to change the product name, repeat the same process. Now, the graph is ready. Let's format it. The link to download the practice file is in the description below. If you like the video, give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you have not yet subscribed. Thank you for watching.